Hey guys, what's up? In this video, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to make your very first WordPress plugin. Now, this plugin is going to be very simple, and it's just going to be a page on the WordPress admin dashboard. And it's really easy to do, and you can do a bunch of things. So let's say you're building a website for a client, but you want to have a custom plugin for them to change options on their website, contact you, white label your own WordPress installation, that kind of thing. Well, that's what these videos are going to be for. Now, in order to actually make this plugin, you are actually going to already need to know how to code in HTML and PHP, and it's good to know some JavaScript and CSS, but it's not necessarily required. I already have a series on HTML. I'll have the link for that in the description below. And if you want to learn PHP, I'll have a link to a great series on PHP. I decided that there's already so many series on that already online that I figured why bother doing one. But if you want to see me make a PHP series, just let me know in the comment section below. All right. So let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing you need to do is have an installation of WordPress, which we do. And since we have that all done, I'm going to go ahead and make a new plugin. So how do you do that? Well, first thing you need to do is you need to organize your file structure. So go into your WP content folder on your server, go into your plugins folder, and then make a new folder and call it whatever you want. It honestly doesn't matter. Just make sure the folder doesn't exist. So I'm just going to call this example-plugin. All right. Now in that folder, I'm going to make a new file. And I'm just going to change the syntax real quick to PHP. And now I'm going to save this in my WP content and then followed by plugins and example plugin. And I'm going to call this index.php. Now, you may be saying, okay, now it's going to show up here, right? So just refresh. No, that's because you need to fill in some basic information. And I'll have an example template in the description for you guys, so you don't have to worry about that. And all you have to do is use this template, and all you have to do is fill this out. So plugin name, I'm just going to type in example plugin. Plugin URL, I'm not going to worry about that. That's like if you want to publish it somewhere on a website, either there, or if you actually want to submit this plugin to the WordPress gallery, which I'm not going to do. Description, example plugin for YouTube, author, MTT, author URL, whatever. You can just put your YouTube link, I don't know, your business brand. So there we go. Version, I'm just going to put 0.1 for now because this is just a beta. All right. So now that you have that, if I go ahead and hit save, now it should show up. If I go over here, and I refresh, you see it says example plugin for YouTube by MTT version 1.0, and I can go ahead and activate it. All right, cool. So your plugin is active, but let's actually go ahead and create our first thing. So this plugin is just going to be like a Hello World style drop down menu item. So before we get into that, so I'm just going to show you. So all these menus, essentially, we're going to add another tab and you can add pages to it. So let's get started. All right, so the first thing you want to do is tell WordPress that you want to add an action, and that action is going to be add a menu to the admin dashboard. So you want to type add_action, admin menu. And if you want, I will have the link to this project in the video description if you're watching this on YouTube. And I'm just going to call this function add menu because that's actually what I called it up here. So you're saying add action, admin menu, and it's the function admin menu. And in this add menu function, we're just going to do the first one, which is I want to add a menu page, and it's actually a group of pages. So, and then the first thing you will put in is the page title. So example options followed by the menu title, so the main menu title. So I'm just going to call this the same thing, example options, and then followed by the capability. So these are the people that can actually access your website. So I will have a link to a bunch of different roles, but I want only editors and administrators to edit. So I am going to put 4 or 5, it doesn't matter, for editors. And then I'm going to put the menu slug, so that's actually in the URL. So I'm just going to put example-options for now. And then, so we have all that. Now the function that contains all the page. So I'm just going to call this example menu. And then followed by an icon URL, if you want to set one. I'm not going to set one. And then the position. But by default, it'll just be at the bottom, which is fine by me. All right, so we have that. So let's just save that. Come back, refresh. So here you can see we now have an option. And it says it's giving you an error because you actually have not made that function yet. But the menu appears. So let's go ahead and make that function. So as you can see, we have example menu as the name of the function. So let's go ahead and make that function. So I'm going to just go down a few lines and call this function example menu. And like I said, this is for someone that obviously knows some PHP already. If you want to just go ahead and mess with the code a little bit, whatever, you can, but I recommend finishing this video. And then followed by whatever you want to appear on the page. So I can just put echo hello world, and then boom. If I go back and I refresh the page, you can see it says hello world. Now, that's cool and all, but let's say you want to add another page. So I'm going to go back into my add menu function, and then I'm going to do add, this time submenu page. And now you need to say what you want it to be a submenu of. And I called it example-options. And if you actually look over here, you can actually make it one of these submenu under here. So if you want them all under settings, you can do that. I'm not going to do that. But like I said, I'll have more information for everything you need to know in the description. All right, now I just want to give it a page title. Option one, and then again, just repeat it. I don't know why they do that, but whatever. You have your page title, your menu title, capability four is fine. Menu slug, example, option one is just going to be my slug, and then menu. I'm just going to call this option one as my function. So now, once again, I can just go down here and call option one and then put all my code I want in here. And I'm just going to put, walrus. And then if I go back here and I refresh arrow on line 18, that's why it's important that you make sure you watch out for semicolons, people. You need to do that, otherwise you might crash your WordPress plugin. All right, so now we have an option one menu that says walrus and an example options one that says whatever. But let's say you just have a bunch of HTML and you don't want to learn how to code. That's fine. I mean, I use this a lot. You can use the here doc syntax just fine. And I'm just going to copy and paste this. And boom. All right, so I copied and pasted that. It just says coming soon. And you can put whatever HTML you want within there and don't have to worry about PHP at all. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you've enjoyed it, make sure to give it a thumbs up on YouTube. Hit the subscribe button and make sure to circle me on Google+. The link for that will be in the description, as well as on Facebook and Twitter. I'm going to be using that a lot now. So it's the best way to find out when more tutorials are coming out. And if you want to communicate with me, you can do so that way as well. And don't feel afraid to shoot me an email at admin@ticktubecentral.com, and I will get back to you shortly. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will catch you guys in a future MicroTech tutorial.